My name is Carissa Johnson. I'm 26 years old and I'm a nurse from Fleetwood, North Carolina. I currently live in Valencia, California because I am here on a travel assignment. With that being said, I just wanted to make a quick video and nominate my hero, who also happens to be my very best friend and my sweet grandmother, for the Pay It Forward Home Edition. I can't think of a person who is more deserving of a new home than my sweet grandmother. She sacrifices so much in her life and has sacrificed so much in her life so that other people can have what they want rather than what she needs. I would say that her financial downfall began around 2002. She took an early retirement from a job which she made a pretty decent living at to help take care of my grandfather, who was diagnosed with Alzheimer's, who she was actually separated from at the time. So she didn't get her entire retirement pension like she should have received. Not only did she help take care of my grandfather, but she helped raise me, my siblings, my cousin, and also my great-grandmother, her mother, until she passed away in February of 2014. My parents divorced when I was around 4 years old. My mother remarried to a guy who was an alcoholic and was also a drug addict. Of course, she fell right into the lifestyle and began doing drugs as well. He was very abusive towards her and towards myself and my brother also. Eventually, social services stepped in and gave her an ultimatum, which basically said, you know, you're gonna either have to divorce him or we'll step in and take your children. So she did divorce him, but I felt like after that, our relationship was really strained. So, she got remarried after she divorced her second husband. Probably maybe a year after she divorced her second husband, she got remarried. We still couldn't get along, so I moved in with my grandmother when I was in the seventh grade. My grandmother raised me without a dime of child support. My mother got child support from my father. However, my grandmother never saw a penny of it. She bought me my very first car. She took me to cheerleading practice. She, you know, she encouraged me to do anything and told me that I could do and be anything that I wanted to be in life. I knew that I wanted to be a nurse from a very young age, and she encouraged me, you know, all the way. I would not be who I am today or where I am today if it was not for her. And, you know, it's because of her 100%. When I was in nursing school, she would wake up at 4 a.m. To iron my scrubs and to cook me breakfast and to start my car. Even though I would tell her not to do those things, she would still get up and do them anyways. Not only that, but she also helps take care of my sister's oldest daughter, who is 3 years old. And they are going to have to move pretty soon, because the state is widening the road and they're going to build part of the highway on her property. So she has to find another place to live. She lives in Ashe County, North Carolina right now, which is really, really cold in the wintertime, and she hates the cold. She tells me all the time that she wishes she had the money to move away from that small town and that cold area. So she would love to relocate. I would be so honored if I could just be given the opportunity to help her out and to help her get out of you know, the financial stress that she's under. No 78-year-old should have to struggle to pay their bills or, you know, to wonder where their next meal will come from. So I'm pretty competitive. I will fight for anything that I love and that I want, and I really, really want to, you know, help give my grandmother the house that she deserves. So I think I would do really good on the show, and I'm pretty crafty. I live in my RV when I'm out of town, so I don't have a whole lot to show you. I did make this little thing for my a shadow box. I do a lot of distressing, so if you can see that, it's kind of a glare, but anyway, I do a lot of that type of stuff. I like to make wreaths. I like to do a lot of stuff. But like I said, I live in my RV, so I don't have a lot to show you. But thank you so much for your consideration and your time. And I really, really hope that I'll be able to give my grandmother the dream house that she deserves. And it's for the As for the $100,000, I don't even want the $100,000. I just want my grandmother to be able to have a nice house that she deserves. I would take the money and help her furnish her house and help her buy a new car, and also donate the rest of the money to charity, because I feel like the best things in life are free, and I live a pretty comfortable life as it is. Thank you so much. Bye.